Hello everybody, today we are going to learn about prevention and treatment of vitamin D and rickets.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Here we have our special guest who is eating his mixture. Namava. And we are going to read about this. This is a 2022 Indian Academy of Pediatrics guidelines. This is an update from the 2017 Dr. Kadilkar et al's update. So why was this update given? This update was given taking into account the Indian scenario with our geographical location in place, with our skin color tone in place. So what are the modifications? Let's get to know. Vitamin D deficiency is still an emerging problem. We are nowhere near completely correcting it. And it can manifest with both skeletal and non-skeletal manifestations. Vitamin D deficiency in this matter. What they have seen is it's associated with infection, especially pneumonia, inflammation, malignancy, mental health problems, apart from your usual typical skeletal manifestations. So how do you define a vitamin D deficiency? So vitamin D deficiency is defined based upon your 25 hydroxy vitamin D levels. Okay, anything less than 12 nanogram per ml. Every word is important. It is nanogram per ml of 25 hydroxy vitamin D, which is called as deficiency. 12 to 20 is insufficiency, and more than 20 is sufficient, meaning it is sufficient enough to maintain our regular needs. Okay, and these levels are closely related to skeletal outcomes. All right. But the non-skeletal outcomes, they do not have the serum level correlation. So less than 12, more than 20. Two levels you remember. And the kutti papa ka vitamin D deficiency vandhu less than 12 paiduthiri chalno level. Nethukku. Adhu vandhu mamme chaapadle ame correcta. Mixture mattum chaapadrindu dhame. நோக்கு வராது கவலை நோக்கு விட்டமின் டி சப்ளிமெண்ட் கொடுக்கலாம் நான் கொடுக்குறேன் அண்ணது கொடுக்கலாம் சொல்றேன் So less than 12 is deficiency. More than 20 is normal. நீ சாப்பிட்ட உனக்கு நார்மலா இருக்கும் 20க்கு மேல இருக்கு லெவல் ஓகே நோக்கு தான் அண்ணது நான் சொல்றேன் டிஸ்டர்ப் பண்ணாம கேட்கணும் அதே 50 to 100 nanogram per ml. See, if you find a level of this 50 to 100, it is unusual to have this level without supplementation. So make sure that they are on supplements, and if they are on supplements, stop any further supplementation because they are already over and above what is required.
இந்த
கதை போறாதா மிச்ச வாழ்க்கலாம் வேணும்டா ஓகேவா மோர் தென் 100 இஸ் டாக்ஸிசிட்டி சோ டோன்ட் கிவ் பியாண்ட் தட் சோ எனிதிங் மோர் தென் 100 நானோகிராம் பர் எம்எல் in association with either hypercalcemia with or without hypercalciuria is known as hypervitaminosis D. So hypo, you know, less than 12, more than 100 is hyper. So along with hypercalcemia, just remember two values. So more than 3 year age group, anything more than 11.1, 11, you think that it possibly could be a vitamin D toxicity. Above 3 years, meaning 4 to 18 years, more than 10.7 is considered as significant. Okay, hypercalciuria, depending upon calcium creatinine ratio in urine, it is less than 0.8, 0.6 and 0.2 in less than 6 months, 6 to 12 months and more than 12 months. Or if you feel you are not able to remember these many values, just say any 24-hour urinary calcium level more than 4 mg per kg per day is significant. இந்த பாப்பாவுக்கு ஒன்றும் ஆகலை ஓகேவா அந்த பாப்பா ரிக்கெட்ஸோட வந்திருக்கு ஸோ விட்டமின் டி லெவல்ஸ் மெஷர் பண்ணணும் ஹவு டு மெஷர் டூ வேஸ் டு மெஷர் ஒன் இஸ் பை இம்யூனோஅஸ்ஸே வேர் தே யூஸ் ஆன்டிபாடிஸ் டு சி ஹவு மச் விட்டமின் டி இஸ் தேர் தி அதர் ஒன் இஸ் லிக்விட் க்ரோமடோகிராஃபிக் மெத்தட் Among these two, immunoassay is easily available. It is low cost. And the liquid one, the correct kandupidikum vitamin D level. Okay, yeah? Whereas in the immunoassay, tappa tappa kandupidikum. Why? Because it can be affected by...
Rectangle
one, the tone. Rectangle one, yes. So, your immunoassays can misinterpret your vitamin D levels based upon your body protein. So that can change your vitamin D level interpretation. And it will not be able to differentiate between your vitamin D metabolite, like 24, 25 hydroxy vitamin D3. And it cannot differentiate between other vitamin D types, like D2 and D3. So you will definitely not be able to make out what is the expected 25 hydroxy vitamin D that you want. If you actually want a specific value or the right value, you should go for liquid chromatographic methods using UV, ultraviolet, or mass spectroscopy. So this is how you say diagnosis of vitamin D less than 12 deficiency, how you do the assay, immunoassay, or liquid chromatography. And the papa has a kidney disease. So for prevention of vitamin D, how do you do? And in whom do you do? Any high-risk patient, you give routine vitamin D supplementation. Whom do you say high-risk patient? Any neurological problem. Okay, cerebral palsy, neuromuscular disorder, chronic kidney disease, chronic liver disease, malabsorption, or a patient who is on medications like steroids, anti-epileptic medications. So these can decrease vitamin D absorption and can result in vitamin D deficiency. Any endocrine disorders like hyperparathyroidism. Extensive cutaneous involvement, skin problem irukku, adanal vitamin D A adanal produce panna mudiyala. So in these you do a routine vitamin D supplement. How much do you give? So in term babies, 400 international units per day you supplement. Childhood, 400 to 600 international units. Preterms, 400 to 800 international units, but there is no specific recommendation to say 800 works better than 400. This is IAP recommendation. Okay, and more than 400 in a term baby does not provide any additional benefit. Any supplementation more than 1600 units per day results in toxic levels. So let's come to your same recommendation. High risk le vandu they say 400 international units per day. Childhood le they say 400 to 600. So these are all fine. But what they say is in childhood and adolescence, unlike your term babies where you advise supplementation by a vitamin D supplement till 1 year of age, they don't say they have to take this as a medication. They say this 400 to 600 international units has to be taken in by diet and sun. So as far as sunlight goes, you need UVB rays between 290 and 350 nanometer wavelength. So what does it do? It converts 7D hydroxy cholesterol to pre-vitamin D3, which gets converted to cholecalciferol, vitamin D3. And then it undergoes all your hydroxylation in liver and kidney. Right? This conversion is linear in the first 30 minutes. Then it sorts of peak by around 8 hours. All right. So how much this gets converted depends on host factors and environmental factors. Let me pause and give him some mixture. Mixture filled, recording, we will resume. Sariya? Okay? So it depends on host factors and environmental factors. Host factors are what? You need to see the age of the patient. Why? Because till old age, your 7D hydrocholesterol levels remains constant, beyond which it reduces. Surface area depends on younger age have more surface area, older age group has lesser surface area. In the sense, face constitutes 7 to 10%, forearm around 8%, hand around 4%, lower leg 8 to 12 and feet is 8. So all of this together constitutes about 40% in young children, whereas the same amount of exposure in an older age group will constitute only around 30% of body surface area exposure. Okay, then next comes duration. So duration anywhere between 30 to 45 minutes is ideally expected if you have to generate your daily requirement of vitamin D. Then skin melanin content, of course, we generally have more melanin content compared to whites. And any sun barrier cream unnecessarily on top of this melanin content is going to reduce your production of vitamin D. So your recommendations also reflect upon these basic factors. So what do they say? 17 to 30 minutes in an infant or 30 to 45 minutes in old children with exposure of 15 to 40% to body surface area at least 5 times in a week from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. If you are able to achieve this, you will be able to achieve enough vitamin D levels in your body. So this is about your sunlight. How do you achieve the same thing through diet? See, through diet, achieving the whole requirement is going to be very, very difficult. Okay, so for example, your vitamin D rich foods, all of us know, fish, liver, cod liver oil, in as D3 content. Calcium is rich in your coarse cereals like ragi. It's good in chickpeas, green leafy vegetables and all that. But the problem with this is, even though you say it is rich, the content you need to take in to achieve the daily recommended amount is huge. For example, in milk, it has around 40 international units per liter. This is in a non-skimmed full fat milk. Okay. So if you have to take 400 international units per day, you will have to drink 10 liters of milk. He anyways is not going to take milk. Even I can't take 10 liters of milk. Butter, similarly, 1 liter has only 30 international units of vitamin D. So I am not trying to say you should not take these at all. So take these in your daily life as much as you usually take. You don't have to overdo it. You don't have to underdo it. But don't cut it off completely. So this is about prevention. So whatever we talked now, your 400 international units, 400 to 600 international units. So these are all for prevention of vitamin D. Okay, so before it happens. Suppose it has already happened. So what do you do? How do you treat? You treat patients with symptoms. Whom do you screen? You screen people with high risk. Your brain, your kidney, your liver, your gut, your skin problems. So these patients, you screen them for vitamin D deficiency and if found to have deficiency, you treat them. But you don't routinely screen for healthy individuals. No, phone
number.
Deficient. Okay, so you treat symptomatic people and anybody incidentally found or screened and found deficient levels less than 12 nanogram per milliliter, CML. You go ahead and treat them. So how do you treat them? You have to treat them with vitamin D and calcium supplements. How are you going to give? You should ideally prefer a daily regimen. Daily is preferred compared to intermittent because it is more preferred, because it is more physiological. And between D3 and D2, it does not make a lot of difference. So both are equal. Whereas if you want to give it as intermittent dosing because you seriously think this patient is not going to be compliant, you can go ahead and do it in equivalent doses to your daily amount. If you are going to give intermittent, give D3 compared to D2 because D3 has more half-life. All right. So that is about daily versus intermittent. So if somebody asks you what you want to give, you will give a daily treatment of vitamin D and calcium. Oral versus parenteral. Oral is always preferred because it is more physiological. And you should always, always give it along with calcium supplementation, which is 50 to 75 milligram per kg per day in divided doses. Maximum don't cross 500 mg. You can go for a calcium carbonate or a calcium phosphate preparation. Young child already having a deficient phosphate levels, then go ahead and give a calcium phosphate supplementation rather than a calcium carbonate supplementation. Okay, so you saw how we are going to give daily, you are going to give orally, you are going to give along with calcium. How much are you going to give? Less than 12 months, 2000 international units 20. Per day. 20 male and the normal vitamin D. 12 deficient vitamin D. Okay, wow. So less than 1 year, 2000 units. More than 1 year, 3000 units. Simple. So don't confuse yourself with too many numbers. Less than 1 year.
Too many numbers.
Na. Less than 1 year, 2000. More than 1 year, 3000.
No, my happy birthday is going to come.
Ama, oh, happy birthday varapurthu. Okay, so after you complete this treatment dosage, continue with maintenance dosage. So that will be 400 units for less than 12 months and more than 12 months, 600 international units. So give this for 12 weeks along with calcium supplementation. If at all you are going to do an intermittent dosing, do the intermittent dosing only for more than 1 year. More than 1 year age group, how do you give? You give 60,000 international units every 2 weeks for a total of 5 doses. So total it will come to 3 lakh international units. So you have started this vitamin D. How are you going to monitor? You will monitor by doing an X-ray at 4 weeks. What do you want to see at 4 weeks? You want to see whether there is a line of healing or not. No, if there is a line of healing, அந்த அண்ணாக்கு எக்ஸ்ரே பண்ணி பார்த்தோம். அது விட்டமின் டி ஒர்க் ஆகுறதா இல்லையான்னு
சொல்லிட்டு
இல்லைனாக்க வந்து இட் இஸ் நாட் டியூ டு விட்டமின் டி டெபிஷியன்சி ப்ராப்ளம் ஆர் என்னன்னு சொல்றது. It's a non-vitamin D dependent rickets. So you will have to look for other causes, non-nutritional causes of rickets. Either parental vitamin D might be required or it might not be responding to vitamin D because it's probably a renal rickets or something like that.
You're not germs stop to do vitamin D.
That's all in the germs stop to don't. So 4 weeks you will look for line of healing. If it is present, complete the 12-week course followed by your regular supplementation. If line of healing is absent at 4 weeks, then it is non-nutritional cause. You will work up for resistant rickets. Then you will repeat the X-ray at 12 weeks along with your biochemical parameters. Okay, biochemical parameters will be serum calcium phosphate, alkaline phosphatase, 25-hydroxy vitamin D. What is it that you want to look for? What you will be looking for is whether your whether in X-ray the problem that you started with has resolved completely. If it has resolved completely, go ahead for maintenance doses. Very good, Richala. Go ahead for maintenance doses. If X-ray is showing incomplete correction, including biochemical parameters, wait for now. அப்புறமா நான் கிளாஸ் முடிச்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஓகே சொல்லு சொல்லு போடு சத்தம் போடப்படாது ஓகே ஆமா ரெக்கார்ட் ஆகும். ஸோ இஃப் எக்ஸ்ரே ஷோயிங் இன்கம்ப்ளீட் கரெக்ஷன் தென் யூ வில் கண்டினியூ தெரப்யூட்டிக் ப்ரோசஸ் ஓகே பிகாஸ் ஈவன் அட் தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் 12 வீக்ஸ் தி விட்டமின் டி லெவல்ஸ் ஹாவ் நாட் கரெக்டட் யுவர் விட்டமின் டி ஹாஸ் நாட் கரெக்டட் யுவர் எக்ஸ்ரே சேஞ்சஸ். All right, so you will continue therapeutic doses beyond 12 weeks also. That's all about the recommendations for vitamin D, both treatment and prevention. Bye bye. Sorry about the lot of background noise.